Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. We thank you so much for tuning in yet again to another episode of What is in the Night Sky this month. Tonight I'm going to be taking you through a beautiful tour of the night sky in the month of August, where we're going to be visiting deep sky objects, solar system phenomenon, and as always, we're going to see what the moon and the planets are up to. Buckle in and let's see what's really out there. First object on our list is an open cluster and one that is visible with the naked eye and is also a beautiful sight through any type of optics. Messier 11, the Wild Duck Cluster. Found close to the southern border of Aquila, the Eagle, you may be able to glimpse this open cluster with the naked eye under dark enough skies. If not, low power binoculars will show it. Through 8x5 binoculars, it appears small, compact, faint, and globular, with a star-like point on its northeastern edge. The V-shape that gives this cluster its name is readily apparent through telescopes at low magnification. Increasing this magnification to about 50 times will improve the view and reveal a multitude of blue-white stars. The cluster will start to lose shape due to the increased magnification. Next is not a deep sky object, but rather a phenomenon within our solar system, and it's the awaited Perseid meteor shower. While you can always depend on the Perseids to put on a show, they're still affected by the moonlight, just like any other meteor shower. Unfortunately, the moon turns full on the 11th and will remain a nuisance over the next few nights, when the shower is at its peak. If you want to try your luck, you'll need to go outside during the hours before midnight on the 12th. Now there is no escaping the moonlight, but it will be low to the east-southeast horizon, so its brilliance will be lessened as a result. As we travel from our solar system back out into deep space, we're going to visit a beautiful and well-known double cluster, Albireo. Albireo, or Beta Cygni, is a showcase double and a favorite of many. Albireo can be split into a pair of stars, one gold and one sapphire, with almost any telescope with the magnification as low as 30 times. If you're new to visual astronomy, Albireo is a double star that you will not want to miss. Simply a summer showstopper. There's nothing quite like it in the night sky, making this a sight you'll return to view time and time again. Now we're going to go even farther out into deep space and visit Messier 22, a glorious globular cluster. Messier 22 is one of the best and brightest globs in the sky, easily detectable with binoculars. And while it never rises very high in the northern hemisphere, it is still worth seeking out. It appears nebulous through a small telescope with low power, with some resolution being possible with averted vision. Increase the magnification to about 100 times, and the cluster takes on an elongated shape, with larger scopes resolving the loose core. So we're going to bring the tour back to our solar system, and we're going to see what the planets and the moon are up to. Mercury returns to the evening sky with a thin crescent moon to its right on August 28th, and then above it the following night. This month, however, belongs to Saturn. The ringed planet reaches opposition on August 14th and is therefore visible from sunset to sunrise. Its yellow-gold light should be unmistakable in the evening sky, but look for the full moon below it on the 12th. Distant Neptune and Jupiter are best seen after midnight, with the waning gibbous moon appearing to the southwest of Jupiter on the morning of the 15th. Jupiter reaches opposition at the end of the next month and is also currently best observed after midnight. Uranus is visible in the early hours along with Mars, which move into the same binocular field of view as the Pleiades around mid-month. Venus remains a brilliant sight in the pre-dawn sky and is joined by a thin crescent moon on the 25th. The moon itself turns full on the 11th and then new again on the 27th. The last deep sky object we will visit in the month of August is another double star. Actually, it's a double star, and is a favorite among some intermediate visual astronomers. The aptly named double-double shows two stars with binoculars, but scopes and a magnification of about 100 times will show that each star can be split again. You'll immediately notice that all four stars are white and roughly the same brightness. However, what makes these stars truly incredible is that they're all part of the same stellar system. The two primary stars take hundreds of thousands of years to orbit each other, while a fifth element orbits one of the pairs within a period of a few decades. Simply incredible. So we thank you so much for tuning in to What's in the Night Sky August edition. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out in the comments or contact us at highpointscientific.com, and our non-commissioned product advisors will be more than happy to assist. Again, we thank you so much for joining us on tonight's journey. Clear skies.